Hi guys, hope everybody is doing well. I want to start off this episode of Fresh Jazzy Sounds with this crazy, little bit freaky album by Eola called Dang. It's completely vocal, no instruments on it. But I think he used any toy he had in the studio to create this weird but fantastic sound. Sounds a little bit bluesy, a little bit gospel-like. Some songs are more poppy, like this one, which is more recorded a cappella. But most of it is recorded with this haunting sound. It's really, I love this little album. It's really a fantastic album. Eola's real name is Edwin M. White. He worked on it from 2011 to 2015, New York City. And it's released by Leaving Records. The next album is a little bit of a weird album. Can it get any weirder than this? Yes, it can. It's by Otis D. Johnson, a gospel album. It's a reissue from 1978. Yep. He does the singing and the playing, and something must have gone horribly wrong, or a genius is at work, because it really sounds. It sounds beautiful, actually. It really sounds, because of the distortion, it makes this album sound very, very good. But the question is, if the engineer who was working on it, and his name is on the back cover, is Danny Dallas, was he falling asleep with the wrong settings? Or did he change the settings something to something brilliant to make it sound the way it does? It's reissued by Numero Uno. And I think he uses one of the first drum machines. And it reminds me a little bit of a Grace Jones album. But it's time now to go back to the real world. A world filled with jazz funk. HMV from Japan, on a regular basis, reissues albums recorded in the 70s. And in general, they are reproduced in a beautiful way. This album is by Akira Ishikawa, Count Buffalo Jazz and Rock Band. He plays on this album the drums and the African bongo. And the electric piano is by Hiromasa Suzuki. And his name you see back on a lot of different albums. Because I think those studio players recorded a lot of albums together under different names. Skatefold. And Japan has a lot of these albums. I'm really surprised. And they're usually sounding very, very good. Next album is also a jazz funk album by Stan Douglas, Luanda Kinshasa, and that are the two songs on this album. And it has been some time since I've read the liner notes, but it is Stan Douglas is not playing on this album. He does the concept and the editing because it is recorded on video, and all the players are sitting in separate compartments playing their own thing. It sounds a little bit, or it has the vibe of an early Miles Davis album from the beginning of the 70s. Also the way the people are the clothing and the hairstyle. I love this picture of the bass player. And we really tried to create that vibe of the early 70s, and they succeeded. Next is the box set. A box set by Now Again. It is released some time ago. I think somewhere beginning of the 2008. And I say I was lucky to be able to pick up a mint copy. It holds three albums by P. E. Hewitt. I will play the first one. Jawbones. Pure jazz, model jazz, but the amazing thing is P. Hewitt was at the time of this recording only 19. So the first album which is playing is from 1968, this one is from 1969, and the last one in the box set is Winter Winds, which was recorded in 1970. This is also, the style changes a little bit through the recordings, and this one maybe the best one from the set, but it is amazing. It does not matter which one you pick to start, you will automatically take the next one. It's really addictive music. The playing, it is. And the great thing is always with albums by Now Again that they include a booklet with an interview with the artist, and that really makes the experience of these box sets great. Next is a more modern album from 2015, released on Jazzman. It's by Nat Birchall, Invocations. And it's really a very nice mix between modal jazz and free jazz. It's really on that border between the two genres, and that's mainly because Nat is playing more in the free jazz style and the rhythm section is more playing modal jazz. It's recorded in 2014, but released in 2015 in the UK. Album is a really classic jazz funk album, but typically what was happening, jazz funk in the 80s was dead, or at least no one was interested to publish the music. So what you see there, there are a lot of private presses. And this album is Gida Gida, Tight and Tidy. I don't know. Oh yeah, you should know this man. Dahu Abubakar Balewa, pronounced Dahu. Well, I even think that I pronounced it the wrong way with the help of the pronunciation. Nigerian born saxophonist, flautist, African percussionist, composer and arranger. And it's reissued by High Jazz. Originally, released in 1981 by Dabba Music. I'm still trying to figure out if Gira Gira is the name of the band, because it also says Ambiance. I'm a little bit confused. Should prepare it in a better way. That's the last song, and I hope you enjoyed this episode of Fresh Jazzy Sounds. See you next time.